Yeah. Hello, fellow lolsters. Welcome to the next episode of LOL, Love of Literature, where we show you behind the scenes of the publishing process, the writing process, and the entire journey of an author with his book. Today, we have for you an experienced author, a screenplay writer, and also a literary critic. He is a man of many faces, and we are so happy to have you here, Mr. Abdullah.
And Abdullah is from Motihari, a village in Bihar. And he was initially educated in Madrasa and in Urdu medium. And during the 90s, he discovered that George Orwell was from Motihari. And this Orwell's connection with his home district drew him towards literature, he says. And Abdullah's writings have appeared in New York's Brooklyn Rail, India's The Hindu, we all know, Bangladesh's, the Daily Star, Pakistan's Friday Times, among others. His debut film was screened in theaters in 2017, Viram. His first novel, Patna Blues, is the most interesting as for me as a published author. It's being translated into many languages, including Persian, Hindi, Urdu, Kannada, Telugu, Marathi, Malayalam, Bangla, and Tamil. And we welcome Abdullah to LOL. Very glad, Abdullah, you're coming on board. We are going to really enjoy this session. Over to Danya for the first question, please.
Thank you. I am glad to be here.
Thank you so much. Yeah, my first question would be, when you transitioned from writing to, screenplay writing, how did it feel? Was it very organic, or did you have to go through certain changes in your writing style when you transitioned from this to that?
I see myself as a novelist, so basically I am a prose writer, but I also enjoy writing a screenplay and film stories.
We are
So,
not able to hear you. I'm sorry. We're
hello.
not at all able to hear you. It's very, very, very muffled.
Is
Even this is very low. Even if you hold it's low. I can't amplify the voice,
second.
but voice of, yeah.
So, your question was about whether I, sorry, I please repeat the question. I just missed.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. My question was, how was the transition from writing for a novel to becoming a script writer? Was it organic, or did you have to go through a few changes before you went through the transition?
Yeah, yes, of course, because both are the different mediums. So you have to adjust certain things. For example, a lot of descriptions or internal journey of a character or monologues that will not work in a film script because that is a visual medium. So you have some limitations. You have to tell everything through a picture or images. So every writer has to make adjustment when you are shifting from a fiction writing to a screen writing. You have to think of the light, location, and some time of a budget also. If you have given the target to create a script which can be shot within a such and such budget, then you cannot afford to have expensive action scenes or the many locations. So that
Yes.
also make you change the way you draft the script. So there are a lot of changes. For then dialogue become a very important thing for the screenwriting. and you have to give the minimum descriptions. You don't explain everything in a script, because that is director's job. But in a novel, you are writer, you are director, you are actor, so everything you are doing. So you have to tell everything to the, your readers. So that is the big difference. But creative thought process is same. You have to think the beginning, middle, and the end of a story, conflicts, and the character's journey, backstory. All these things are common across the genre, across the media.
So the young people, the contemporary generation of today, they believe failure is just the opposite of success. But they eventually they will understand it. The failure is part of the success, part and parcel of it. You have such an interesting story behind that rejection. You know, people can't take rejection. Whereas your novel was rejected 200 plus times.
More than that. I have records of 200.
That's really going to give so much insight.
Inspire more authors.
Yes, inspire and in fact, you know, give more the perseverance from you. We have so much to learn from. Could you please give us more on that interesting stories?
So just I would like to add something about my background and how I started. That will be interesting for people coming from the different background. So I was born in a village where there was no electricity, no road, nothing was there. No doctor attended my mother. It was like that. It was expected now. So during the childbirth, but no doctor was required. So I came from that background. So, but I was always used to be after my grandma and my mother, my aunts for the story. So story, I was always greedy for the stories. So whenever some relatives visited my house, the first question was, do you have stories? Mm. So bedtime stories was my favorite thing. Even chocolate and ice cream cannot replace those things. So a story was my kind of hobby. So I used to live in my village because my father was in police department in Bihar police, and he used to be frequently transferred. So that time I was in my village. So when I was 8 or 9, I don't remember exactly, but I was just in class 3 or 4, something like that. So my father gifted a book, Bal Bharti, published by Government of India for kids. So first time I came to know that books existed beyond the classroom. So that was the first introduction to the stories, written stories. And I was very happy that now I have I had option to read myself. I need not run after my aunts or mom for the story. So that was the beginning of the affair. Then my father used to tell me, beta, learn English. English is very important. So he was always insisting that I should focus on English. And in Bihar Education Board, English was taught from class 5 or 6. Oh. From class 6. So from class 6, you start learning ABCD. But my father used to tell me, and even I attended some tuition in class 4, 3 to learn English. And so there was something in the back of the mind that someday I will write in English. Not I will be a novelist or writer something, but so when I was helping my brother with his English assignment, I discovered that Eric Arthur Blair was born in my hometown. So I was really surprised and very happy, because Motihari is famous for experiment with Satyagraha in Motihari itself. So it is a historical town, a small town, and this was another thing that I can do or where. So I got the animal farm and read it, and then I start thinking about writing a book of myself. But I was not able to start it properly. In between, I started writing for the Times of India, Hindustan Times, while I was pursuing my BSc degree in chemistry from a Patna college, Patna West College. So, but when Arundhati Roy won the Booker Prize, that was the real inspiration for me. Same evening, I went out, purchased a very expensive pen and very expensive notebook, a spiral bound.
So sweet.
And I started writing. And within a week, I finished 4 chapters and get it typed, electronic typing. It was very expensive, 25 rupees per page.
Oh.
Way back. And all my pocket money or savings, because I used to write for the newspaper. So as a student, I was rich, because whatever my friends were getting from their parents, I was making out of my article more than that. So I was rich that time. So I get it typed and start sending out to the international publisher. And I had read about the David Godwin. So I found out his address, and I also sent. So I spent a lot of money on the speed post, sending to the UK publishers. None of them responded except the Mary Mount. She was a fiction editor at Picado. And she responded that you need to work on your manuscript. Your writing is not publishable in present form. So it has fire, but you need to work. So I was heartbroken and motivated at the same time. At least she responded. So I started working. At that time, I was in my 20s, early 20s. So obviously, mid-20s, you can say, mid-20s. So I was writing some kind of mushy love story kind of thing. Characters were same, but it was chocolate romance, you can say. So in the course of time, it kept evolving, and title also kept changing. Initially, it was called In the Corner of a Heart. Four corners of a heart, a sacred tree, a holy fig, something like that. And then Remains of a Dream. So title kept changing. And Three Kinds of Dream. Then finally,
it's Blues.
Patna Blues. Patna Blues. 2010, something. Not 2010, I think in 2014 or 15, my wife suggested that I should change the title. Title is not conveying anything. And one of my friend, Professor Kishore Ram from Kerala, he was also very, he was not satisfied with the title. He kept telling me that you change the title. And when I changed it to Patna Blues, I sent it to 2 persons in India and got the one of them. David Devidar also responded. He gave me good suggestions. And from Chiki's team, I got a call from Renu Agar, who used to be the head of Hindi department, but Chiki had given her. Unfortunately, Renu passed away last week because of COVID. She was the...
No.
Renu was the responsible for my literary success. She was very kind. She helped me. Because before my manuscript was forwarded to the head of the English fiction, she made me edit a lot of, cut it down, 25,000 words, and advised me that you should get rid of this portion, that after that, she pitched it to the editor at Jagannath Sivapuria, and they immediately called me for the meeting, and we had a lunch together at a Bihari restaurant.
Oh.
So they took me to a very expensive Bihari restaurant where Bihari dishes were. And still, it is very sad to think that Renu died at the young age of 52. She was very nice, very friendly. And for a new writer like me, she was kind of angel, you can say. Otherwise, I would not have been published. So this is how my book was published. And then it has been already translated into 8 languages, and 6 or 7 languages are in the pipeline, delayed because of COVID situation.
So the 200 plus rejections were over a period of how many years? And how many drafts?
I think 10 years, almost 10 years.
How many drafts?
I think 5-6 drafts. If you talk about the first few chapters, I have written more than 200 drafts. First 6 chapters, more than 200 drafts. For entire novel, at least 4 or 5 drafts. Minimum 4 drafts.
Okay.
Because minor changes I am not counting. Actually, after joining bank in 1998, I had given up the writing because I was posted in a remote location in Punjab and was homesick. Okay. I had never been away from my family. So it was very difficult, and I did not know cooking. So food was also an issue because eating out every day was not possible. So, and that was a different kind of food, Punjabi food, I was not used to. So then I gave up writing. Then I got married in 2000. So after marriage, my wife came to live with me in a small town in UP, and it was a typical Indian arranged marriage. So we did not know much about each other. So, and she discovered the old articles and old manuscripts, partial manuscripts. And then she started, "Why did you stop writing?" And she almost forced me, blackmailed me emotionally, bought me a new laptop, and then that time she was all alone. My mother was not with us, so she was all alone. So she told me that you write in longhand, I will type in the computer. So that was the duty given to me. And every morning she used to ask me, "Where is my manuscript? How I will spend my day? So I need something to write." It has become kind of assignment or something. Every night
Interesting.
So that way, once I was half through, then it appeared that I can finish it. And I finished it and sent it to a professional critic. And the feedback was devastating. So in the other words, the critic told me that it is a totally shit. Nothing is there. So, but my wife was unfazed. She told me, "You read her comments." She is some South Indian lady, so she has given a comment. So she asked me to read the comments and see what can you do, how can you fix it. Then I went back to the report, and then I rejected something suggested by her. And then I accepted something. Then I started rework. Then I rewrote the entire, changing the character graph. Then I shared with some of my friends, including Zafar Anjum. Zafar also advised me to remove certain portion in my novel. So that I did. Whatever Zafar told me, I did. And that was a good decision. After that, a couple of friends gave me this. And then I started sending out to the foreign.
So those portions that you removed, suggested by Anjum, Zafar Anjum, just share with us what was the issue there. I mean, because aspiring writers will know what to avoid or what to add, where lies the sensitivity and all that. You can share with us.
Actually, it was about the the main character. So Zafar's argument was that this is not requirement of the story, the kind of character he is. If you are going to add this episodes, it is incorrect, or it is not true that this cannot happen with Arif. The kind of character is there, and when you are portraying a character, you are showing a part of his life. You are not showing everything, every single detail. So he thought this is unnecessary, and this single chapter will give a different shade to the Arif's character. So better to avoid it. There was no need, because it was not adding into the story. So I accepted. And then that chapter was very well written, very poetic. So I was very not wanted.
So you must be writing Urdu poems. Urdu is a poetic language, no?
Yes, 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 that is true.
Okay, so like you said, you had to go through so many rejections. Was there something that you did different? Like if someone had to compare your first draft and the final draft that you have, that has been, now become a book, what is your takeaway from that? What were the lessons that you took through the drafts? And why do you think this fifth draft is worth publishing?
So my first draft and fifth draft, if you talk about the story, there is no much difference, not much difference, except the way I cut down some chapters or redrafted certain chapters. So story line was basically almost same, except some that the ending of the novel or certain characters were given more space like that. This kind of changes were made. Basically, mostly I in the second draft or third draft, I try to improve the language flow of the story and cut down the back stories or the description. That was the main agenda. So basic difference you can say was that I cut down the adjective and adverbs a lot of adjective and adverbs and the back stories. There are certain back stories which were taking us away from the main plot, so that were cut off. And number of characters were more. For in first draft, Arif had 3 friends. But in the subsequent draft, that 3 friends were merged into 1 friend. So when you have a lot of characters, then it becomes very difficult to handle. And it creates confusion in the mind of the reader. So better to...
I was wondering... did the success of the novel lead you to the translation idea, or how did that happen?
Translation, basically, when I started writing, because I came from a small village and I studied in Urdu Hindi medium, and my mother tongue is similar to Bhojpuri. So with my grandmom or my mother, I used to speak in my mother. So most of the writers, when I get into this English fiction writing group, so profile was different, totally different. I attended a University of East Anglia short creative writing course. So when I landed there, I found someone has degree from MIT, someone from Oxford. So there were 22 participants. Majority of them were from India. It was because it was held in Calcutta. So I was surprised. I was the only person with the kind of degree. I did masters in organic chemistry from a small college in Patna. And these guys had so fancy degree. So that time I was not sure that whatever I was doing is the right thing. So I talked to the Ramesh Gunasekara, Booker shortlisted writer from Sri Lanka, who is based in UK. So, Ramesh, your voice is not coming.
My voice?
Hello.
No, we're not talking. No.
We're not talking.
Listening.
You keep listening.
Yeah. So, Ramesh told me, Abdullah, don't doubt your writing skills. At University of Anglia course, we got more than 150 applications from all over the world, and we selected 22. At least trust my sense of judgment. If you cannot trust your writing skills, so we selected you, that means you knew how to write. So that was a kind of solace I got from his words. And then after returning from there, I started submitting with more energy, more vigor. So translation about the translation, it comes to my mind when people started telling me Patna Blues is a Hindi novel written in English. So many people used to tell me why did not you write in your mother tongue. So I told them Hindi or Urdu is not my mother tongue, and there is no takers for Bhojpuri books. So you should not tell me that I should write in my mother tongue, because you presume that the Bihar and UP people are Hindi speakers. None is Hindi speaker, to be honest. And they are either Bhojpuri speaker, Odi speaker, or the Mathi speaker. But they claim, many of them will claim that they are Hindi. So then
people even in India think that the language spoken in Bihar is Bihari. They don't know the name of even the languages which are spoken there.
Actually, Bihari was used by a Scottish linguistic expert for all the languages spoken in Bihari. 5-6 major languages are there. So collectively, they many people call it Bihari. So it was at the back of my mind that it should come in Hindi. Late Renuji, who was heading, he was the editorial director for the Hindi books at Juggernaut. So she told me, Abdullah, I have got you the publishing deal. So you should translate yourself into Hindi for me, because some other people try to write in Hindi, then meaning will be totally different, because the ideas were in Hindi and that were representative English language. Now again, they will go back. The end result will be something very, very different. So you know the local language, local dialect, local culture, folklore. So you should write in Hindi, and it should not be translation. It should be rewritten afresh. And that time I was selected for the translation workshop in Bangalore. That is famous workshop. That happens in Nirithgyam. I just forgetting the name of it. It is a very famous workshop, the translation workshop. So it was conducted by Nita Gupta, Rahul Soni, and Alsia Sattar. So three writers were invited. So I was one of them to translate my English book into Hindi. So at that residency, it was not workshop, it was kind of residency, short-term residency. So I just started working on my novel and in Hindi. So I started writing afresh, and I thought that I should include those idioms, those phrases which could not be included in the English language, because once you translate, fragrance is gone. So in original form, you can't include in the, but in Hindi I could add the Bhojpuri.
So when English or Hindi goes to Bangla or Tamil or Malayalam, Urdu, how is it going? You said you have already lined up the translations and
yes
publication.
Yeah, what happened?
How do you work with those? Sorry, I would add this also. How do you work with the translators? Because like you said, the nuances disappear in the process of translation. So how do you work with the translators? And are there any agents for this translation?
Yes, in India, everything is not routed through agents. There are direct submissions also, and there are agents also. Mm-hmm. So in my case, what happened? When he was to be published by the same Juggernaut books, but subsequently Juggernaut books stopped publishing Hindi books. So they talked to a couple of publishers, and 2-3 publishers were interested. And they involved Kanishka Gupta of Writer's Side for selling the translation rights. They were deployed by the Juggernaut. Incidentally, Kanishka is my friend also. But he is not my agent, my friend also, but he is not my agent. But through Juggernaut, it went to him. And he started pitching to the different publishers, and there were serious interest from two publishers. So there are kind of bidding and auction for the Hindi translation. But the Manjul was also offering Hindi plus Malayalam together. So Kanishka decided to go with the Manjul.
What genre does this Patna Blues come under your novel?
Very difficult to categorize. Some people, especially reviewers, because it is set in 90s, many people like historical fiction. Many people say it is a literary fiction. Many people think that it is not literary fiction because it is very interesting, very engrossing. So a literary fiction must be boring. So these kind of arguments I keep hearing, but it is a general fiction. You can keep in between a... I think there is a word in the Western publishing world. Upmarket fiction.
Upmarket.
So, yeah, a literary fiction which is appealing to the common people.
Mm.
There is a plot, there is a story. It is a literary fiction, but you are taking the some. There's a bit from the commercial fiction also.
Mm-hmm. Like, okay.
So there is a plot.
Mm-hmm.
There are characters are also dealt with like a literary fiction, but you have a plot, I have a story. So this you can bracket in that category. But I don't believe in categorizing. But these are the views of
Course. But it's for listeners to get an idea of what what kind of a book it is. But it was very interesting to note that you what you commented, literary fiction. It shouldn't be interesting.
Okay. Yeah. I think we have to go to our next question. The next question is like you said, because they're translated into many languages, and maybe like I want to know if the translation is so that it could reach many people, or do you want to make it more regional?
Hmm.
The same thing will not work everywhere. Like in India also, like if you take me, I live in South India. So for me, like when you talk about the you know, like the jargons or the usual things that happen in Bihar, I will not be able to relate to it, right? So are you using the translation to make it more global or make it more regional?
Actually, I feel my story is a story of a lower middle class family, which especially for South Asian people, it is very easy to relate. So I got a feedback from a 78 years lady, retired teacher from Karnataka. She had written in longhand, very long letter. So she was able to connect with it. And from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Sri Lanka to Pakistan, Bangladesh to Italy. So I was surprised to observe that everyone was able to find something which was common with my character and that reader. So my purpose was that my story should travel to as much territory, as much as cities possible. So after Hindi and Malayalam translation, I started getting offered from the many publishers. For example, Urdu and Bangla, I got on Facebook. Somebody added me in their Facebook group and asked me if I was interested in getting it published in Bangla. Mm-hmm. For Marathi, I simply sent a copy of the book to the Maharashtra's biggest Marathi publisher. They publish more than 300-400 titles per year.
Mm-hmm.
They also publish some English book, but mostly in Marathi. So I just put a copy of book in the envelope and sent it to them, and they called me home to talk for the rights.
Mm-hmm.
Then for Tamil, it came through Kanishka. Kannada, some writer friend recommended it to a Kannada publisher. Vivek Shonbagh advised me that this publisher might be interested. So there are different stories for the East translation. Something came out of blue. uninvited, and something was routed to my publishers and their publishers agent, and something which for example, when I visited Goa Literature Festival, I got a offer for a Konkani translation from a Goa based publisher. So this kept happening, and my target was to get published in Hindi and all four South Indian languages. That target is completed.
Okay.
Okay,
that's great. That's great. I think we can go on to the next segment with this. I think this would be my last question. After we can go on to the next segment. The last question is, like you said, how useful has social media and literary festivals or like the workshops that you said been through your journey?
You are talking about literary festival or workshop?
All three, literary festivals, workshop, and social media.
First start with the social media. Of course, social media is useful because when you are building a friendship list or you are having a lot of friends on your network who are directly or indirectly connected to the literary activities, or they are literary agent, or they are writers, or the readers, you get the first exposure to them. For example, as I told you, I got the offer for the Bangla translation through the Facebook. So
Facebook.
It was helpful. If he was not there, he would not have offered me this translation deal. So social media helps, but social media will give you exposure to some extent. Rest of the thing will be done by the your students. Once they read, and word of mouth is the best publicity medium. So if you are publishing on, you are advertising on a social media or radio or TV, that will not work as much as the word of mouth. If a very, for example, for in my case, many senior people in the field of journalism or the movie or art know me personally. So many of them tweeted, many of them wrote about the book on Facebook. So that immediately you will see the effect. Next day, the rating on the Amazon will jump. So that happens. And if you have old friends whom you have, because I always offer to help new writers or anybody coming to me. If I can help, I will. So that sometimes comes back to you. People are very passionately pushing your book. There are many young writers whom I used to mentor or help. So they become my ambassadors. So they are telling their friends, but it will not happen in one day. So many of people I know for 10 years, 15 years. So once you develop a relationship without thinking that it will help, then it helps.
That's important.
It actually will help. Okay. And about the festivals and workshops?
Literary festival gives you the visibility. So once you go to the literary festival, so many people attend and your books are sold there, and then media is covered. For example, in Hindu literary festival, I appeared in their newspaper many times. In addition to interview, review, because of festivals, my photos and my description were published in the newspaper. That gives kind of visibility. Achha, ye bhi kitab hai, this book, achha, this writer is coming frequently on the page of Hindu. So we should check out his books. So you get the media. But at the end of the day, it is the quality of your story and how the readers connect with your stories. That will help. If readers like it, even it is very well written, it may end up as a failure. Even it is not very well written, if readers like it, it becomes success. So initial visibility is required, and for that review, literary festivals and social media helps you. And I was lucky because and your writing credential also, because of my articles, reviews, and many other activities, many people, many readers used to know me. So even I got the Jagannath offer, the first question asked by the fiction editor as Jagannath was, "You are the same Abdullah who debuted Amir Khushro and Rumi's translation books in Hindu." Okay, yes. So the editor was aware about my existence even before I pitched. So those books were edited by that editor when she was in Penguin. Okay. So she was aware that this guy is writing. I presume that I would be a very old person with the long beard because I used to write on the very serious things, philosophy and all these things. So she presumed that I would. So she was surprised to see me in the pair of jeans and shirt. So she thought I was expecting a long white beard. So that helps. You have a writing credential. You have already published stories, and then editors and agents will take you seriously. This guy is serious about his writing. He's not just coming with the.
Got it. Yeah. Now it's time for our next segment, which is Word of W's. Word of W's is nothing but all the W questions, like what, when, where, how, and why. And it's a short segment, and it's for the listeners to just crawl to this segment if they're not able to spend time to listen to the entire podcast. So it's like a gist of the entire podcast. So I think I'll start with the first question. The first question is, when is your next work due?
I have finished my second novel. It is called A Man from Motihari. It is about a boy called Aslam who was born in Motihari. And he was born in the same house where Orwell had been born. So he begins to believe there is some supernatural connection with George Orwell. And this has already been submitted to my agent. And she has started submitting to the US publishers. She is US based. My agent is US based. So she has started submitting to the US publisher. But because of this pandemic situation, things have slowed down. Let's see.
Who are your target audience, Abdullah?
So whenever I write for the readers, my audience readers, same thing. So whenever I write, I always first think of myself. If I enjoy writing, I continue. Otherwise, I will immediately delete it from my folder itself. So my readers in mind are everyone, every single person on this earth. So I see myself as a global writer who can appeal to the local as well as global audience. So I want to see my book published in all languages.
Why the connection with George Orwell? What is your inspiration from him?
Basically,
because it's your second novel and you're going back to him, so I would like to know what about him inspires you.
So I visited his birthplace in 2000 or 2001. So it was a kind of vibration I felt when I was there. And it was very proud moment for me. This guy who has a big name in English literature was born in my hometown. So in Hindi, we use the word apnapan. You start feeling connection with someone who comes from. If he is very successful, then his connection becomes very strong. So I feel very connected. And then one day I found about George Orwell's nanny. There was an Indian lady who used to take care of Orwell when he was a kid. So I got to see a photograph in which an Indian lady, poor Indian lady, was holding this 1-year-old Orwell in her lap. So that was the starting point. From then I thought, who was that lady and how her relationship with Orwell was. So that was the starting point. So this novel is about Aslam and his journey, plus a bit about Darwin and a bit about that lady who was taking care of Orwell when he was a kid. Then they moved to the England and she was left behind, but nobody knows who she was and from where she came. She was a poor lady, just employed by the Blair family.
Where can readers find your works, in bits and pieces as well as the books by themselves?
Pardon, I did not get your
question. Where can the readers find your works?
So it is available on Google. You type my name and then you can get. And it is not collected. And book can be purchased from any platform, Amazon, bookstore. So it is available all over the world.
Do you have a blog where you have samples of your works or something?
Yes, yes, yes. There are something, but I am not maintaining this blog in those days. But there is a blog called abdullahkhan.blogspot.com. So there are some links are given there. And some of the old stories and reviews are posted there. So one can look for those materials at the blog.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. I think that's all with the questions. If you have any final words for our audience and about the show or about the show, you can please share with us.
So I really liked your format and your questions because I used to get the same questions from all the journalists and the interviewers. So it was a bit different. So I really enjoyed it. And for the aspiring writers, I have a message. Just keep trying. There is no shortcut and there is no guarantee for success. You may end up with a failure, but at least you have a satisfaction that you tried your best. So I would have given up after 200 rejections. Even I have got more than that. 200 is just, I have recorded those rejections. So I always got 200 plus, but it was more than that. So I was rejected. I was humiliated. I was told to stop writing. I was told to write in Hindi. I was told to write in Urdu. I was told to try something else. So I kept hearing this. And many people who mock me, they are not published. I'm not happy that they are not published. I still want they should be published. Because a Harvard, a Oxford degree or an MFA from any big institute will not help. Only thing is your imagination, your empathy and feelings for your characters and how much you enjoy the writing process. That is the best thing. Whenever I sit and start writing, I feel that I am sitting under the sun during an Indian winter. So that kind of feeling.
Oh,
I always
that's
have.
Lovely.
And right now I am working on a memoir about my growing up in a small village and about identities, how multiple identities works. You that's are a good. Muslim, you are Indian, you are a Bihari, your caste is also one of the identity, class is also identity, sub-caste, sub-sect, so many things.
Yeah.
Right now my agent suggested that I should write on that. So I am working on that.
Oh, lovely. Lovely. Very good. All the best for your works.
Thank you. Thank you for inviting me for this podcast. All the best.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye. Take care.
You can switch the recording off.